Morning. All right, tonight we're going to talk about some various different parts of, various different parts of Facebook and ways that you can use them. Now, if you're really, really brand new, you may not use the Facebook page yet or like page, but if you've gotten a little bit more acclimated to Facebook, like I have, that is kind of a business entity that you can use to kind of build your brand and your business. So we have three different entities really to think about in Facebook. You have your profile here, and then you have what we call a fan page or a like page. And then there is also the groups. And they went through a tremendous change over the past few months. And you can usually get to them from your front page if you have been in any of the groups at all. For instance, we've got some of our basic groups that we all are part of, like this one. And this one is not so that you can find people to talk to, but it's more about keeping up with what's going on in our BWB with trainings and help like that. Or if people like myself want to post, this is actually a business, not a business link. This is a Facebook note, which I can teach you how to use, and that's one of the tools that Facebook has. So feel free as we're going along to put in questions in the chat box as well. I'm going to just jump back and make sure everything's running right. Looks like it is. So we're out and going. All right. So tonight I'm going to talk to you a little bit about how you can use lists and especially be able to function in all of these other entities with a list and with sharing, because that's one of the really powerful ways that you can start to create a little bit of interest in you and in what you're trying to offer. Now, I don't recommend you're spamming, but there are lots of ways, like for instance, right here, I did one, and this is actually a note that I created over in my own profile. And I did that so that I could just, share something that I thought was valuable. And it was actually a part of my blog, which is something that I can recommend that you can do. You don't have to come recreate your content completely new all the time. You can use a part of it in different places if it's your own original stuff. In this case, it was something that I was writing, and I used it in three places. I used it here, I used it in my blog, and I used it over in Better Networker, and I also made a video. So it was one piece of content used four different ways in four different places. And that's one of the things you can do. You don't have to make it so hard, you know, to get something out there in front of people. Yeah, I'm hearing that, Sam, and I have the mic right up against my mouth. I'm not sure what else I can do for you. Sometimes the reception isn't real good. I'm doing the best I can on that. So if you get the benefit of pretty much what I'm doing, what you can do is definitely practice some of this too. One of the things I do think that really matters here is that you want to not just listen to me tell you about things, but actually try to put some of it into practice. The more you can put it into practice, the better it will work for you. Now, here's another thing to pay attention to. When you go back to my actual home page, which is my profile, they used to put lists up here in this right here under the arrow. They took all that out. You might notice this is pretty short now. It used to have a lot more in it. They've taken a lot of that away and put it on the profile or on the home page. Now, a lot of people are having a little problem with that, but actually I think when you get used to it, it's going to be more convenient. For instance, the majority of the things that have to do with your personal profile, like your friends and the things that you put on here, are going to be right here, right on your profile under your picture. For instance, your friends, when you look at your friends, you can actually edit right inside of this folder now. And the way that works is, for instance, we have this fellow here and he's already a friend. But if you scroll over to where it says friends, you can actually change your list with that person if you want to. For instance, if I thought that he might need to go to a different list, I could add him to a different list. And you might notice that I have quite a few things in here as a list, and this is things that I've created. And to create a new one, all you have to do is click this plus button on the very bottom. Now, this is a scroll down that comes up when you click on the friend button right here. So I'm pointing at it long enough, I hope you can see it. This is where you go to change where that person is in your list or to create a new one. Or you can even cancel or unsubscribe right there. It lets you do that. You can unfriend, cancel a request, and you can add them to a list, all here on this page. Now, why am I telling you all this? Because this is helpful in order to know about these people when you go to want to spend some time talking to them or working with them. For instance, if I went to one of my lists here, like for instance, these are my fan pages or like pages here, and say I wanted to go to my list that I'm calling affiliate marketers, which they can be invited to use Better Web Builder as well, so it's a good idea to work with them too. If you click on affiliate marketers, oh, it doesn't let me do it there. They change this around, so it's fun to find it. But another thing you can do right here is if you want to talk to people, a specific group of people, you can actually type in something that you're interested in and see who comes up that are part of your friends list. For instance, I'm interested in music. Let's make it real general. Whoops, we don't need that. What's that? Okay, so music, let's see what comes up when I do that. It'll take a moment to populate it. It doesn't bring anything up. So let's try network marketing. That's interesting. Oh, there we go. So see, it brought people up that has that on their profile, network marketing, and they're all friends in my friends list. So if I wanted to speak to one of them because I know that they're a network marketer, I come down and make sure I've got somebody that's not in Better Web Builder, because I don't go and cross recruit if I can help it. So let's go look at Beth. And I like to open it in a new tab. See how we're doing. Is that any better? Can you hear me any better? Okay, perfect. Maybe it just straightened itself out. Hard telling. Okay, so I opened up this lady. She's in my friends list, and she came up because of the network marketing tab that I decided to check out. And I haven't talked to her in a while. And I'll just see what she's up to, because she can change that, you know, even though I might have chosen to put her in that particular section of my list, she may have changed what she's doing. So it's a good idea to check it out once in a while. She's in health and wellness, so that's a pretty good sign that she's still in network marketing. And I don't see a link. So she may not be showing too much here. Let's see what she's doing on her wall. And I'm looking just for things to kind of connect with her about. And that's kind of something that it's a good idea to do. Once you have a little bit of a list, you don't really have to continually get brand new people all the time. I don't know what stick is. That's something that somebody is recommending. I don't see her doing very much on her wall. All of this posting is other people. Somebody likes shoes, apparently. So I don't see her actually posting anything. And she has over 4,000 friends. I don't know what that means, why she isn't posting. But something could have happened. Okay. So are you handling being able to hear pretty good now? All right. So another way that we can use our lists is to come over to the home page. Well, actually not the list, but the groups and the fan pages and our personal home page. See, we have a lot of places where we can actually save something. Here is something that I did earlier, but I'm going to do it again. Find something that I like enough to share. And be careful what you decide you're putting your name on. If it's kind of raunchy, I wouldn't do it. Because it's just too easy to get kind of bad mouthed if you do the wrong things here. I don't see something. I've got to come through here slower, I guess. I don't like these cartoons. Now, a lot of people are sharing them. One thing I do like that people are sharing is these kind of things, these little posters. I don't know whether they're making them themselves or they're just finding them somewhere. But I think those are pretty nice. And be careful not to say things that sounds kind of nasty. That's cool. This one here. Let's see, what do I want to share? Or if somebody shares a video of some good music that you like. Or you can even go over to YouTube and share something that you like there. I steer clear of things that are political and religious, mainly because there are so many different kinds of religion. What will be great for some will be offensive to others, and it's really important not to try to offend all of the different people that you have. You don't know what their beliefs are, whether they're religious or political. It doesn't matter, but it's important to keep it as generic and open as possible. Okay, I'm not finding anything too exciting. That's gorgeous. That looks like, that actually looks like Colorado. I wonder if it is. So I'm going to share this. Now I want to show you something before I'm not sending this to my wall actually. What I'm going to do is show you that you can actually share this in all other kinds of other places, not just your wall. That was our only choice at a long time, but now you have on your page, if you have one of your, if you already have a like page, in a group, if you're in a group, on a friend's wall. Now this is okay if it's not something that is controversial to a friend. Like for instance, I can share this to Juanita Waterman's wall because she's one of my upline and she doesn't mind that kind of stuff. But you have to know who you're sharing it with and whether they would appreciate that or not. But especially share it in groups if you're part of a group. And the way you do that is first you say group, and then you can just start to type it. Start to type the word, and in my case, I'm going to put it on my own wall because I know this is one of my groups, so I know I can share it in there without any controversy. And then that just gives them something fun to look at that is not about network marketing. Because you don't always have to be about network marketing. Sometimes you just want to do something that looks like you're a human being that likes things. For instance, just earlier, I shared this picture, and I don't know if you can see it. Probably you'd have to go to my profile to see it more clearly, but this is a picture of a mother tiger in a zoo, and she lost her babies because they were premature, and so she was starting to get sick because she was depressed about losing her babies. So they found the same amount of little piglets, and this is really a cute story. You'll have to come and read the whole story. But she found some little piglets and wrapped them in a little piece of fur that looks like tigers, and now she's babying and mothering these piglets, and since they're still young enough to suckle, she doesn't seem to know the difference that they're not her own babies. And so it made her come back to life and feel a little more happy about things because she has something to love. You know, animals are not much different than humans in that way. They need that. So, I hope everybody can hear okay. And that is one of the things you want to do is to share. Oh, that's the wrong one. To share things that are not just your own link, not just your own blog, but other things that you find attractive and would even maybe create a little bit of conversation. Because when you can create conversation on your wall, like right here, you can see that that's happening, then that helps to bring people to you. And when people like something that you post, like here, it also brings people to you because every time all of these people have liked it, all of their friends will notice this. And I've already seen people pick this up and actually share it from mine. See, I've got two shares already. And when that happens, your name shows up every time there's something that gets shared. Now, even though this isn't about business, it's helping to build up your attention with everybody else. You could share, if you liked it well enough, anywhere you want and as many times as you want. You're certainly not limited. Facebook doesn't keep you from doing that, and they actually encourage you to do this kind of stuff, sharing this picture, because sharing pictures, sharing stories that you like, sharing notes that you like, and sharing videos that you like, it's all part of community. And I say that a lot because when we're trying to build a business, community is a part of that. So are there any questions? Does that make sense to you, I hope? I don't see any action, so I guess there isn't any. All right. And another thing I just learned about, let's see, that's not what I want to do, is when you go to your Facebook page, and this isn't going to be so much about telling you how to make a Facebook page, but how to use it to build up more of your fans and to create something more here. For instance, earlier in the day, as money, a lot of you already know, because I did this in the main big group, the Better Web Builder on and offline group, I created an event, but I shared it over here on my Facebook page. I shared it in all my pages, and I shared it on my wall, and I shared it in any of the groups that I was part of that pretty much I'm the admin of. So instead of having to create the event three or four times or five times or however many places you want to share it, I only created it once. So if you click over here, you'll see that it's actually the same one that you probably saw, and that's why you came to tonight's training. But I shared it at the Facebook page, and I shared it on my own personal profile. And that way it was possible for a lot of people to see it. And that's very, very important, especially if you've got something good to share. Now this, of course, with being a good training, and it's generic, you can always share this on your wall too if somebody is doing a training, whether it's me, Juanita, or whether it's one of the Better Web Builder trainings, or even if it's somebody else in the team that's doing something. Share it on the wall. Share it on your Facebook page. Share it in your groups. Whenever you can do that, that helps to build up. People will see these. These show up on the main feed when you do a lot of sharing. Okay, still don't see questions, so I guess you're okay. All right. So again, we're doing things that are increasing our visibility and helping people see that we have things to share that are of value. And guess what that does also? It increases this number. People come over and like your page or come and want to be your friends in your Facebook profile because they see things that you share in other groups and in other fan pages that are of value. But I warn you again, don't do it with Better Web Builder stuff in other people's groups. They don't like that. But share something of value like I did with my note earlier. I even shared this in a great big group that is, I'll go back over there and show you. I shared that note in, find the group. Oh, I know how to find it faster than that. I shared it in, where are you? It's not coming up. Well, anyway, do you have questions while I'm waiting for that to come up? Everybody can still hear me? Everybody's able to see? Perfect. All right. All righty. That wasn't what I wanted. Okay, we'll go back to the home page. You know what? You don't have to be perfect to train. You just have to have the desire to help people. I can promise you that I'm not perfect at any of this. So, a lot of the time, I learn things by experimentation. I know that sounds like an odd thing because there's people that are afraid to experiment. But I promise you it's a good thing to do that because you can't really make a mistake on Facebook. Okay, here it is, right here. It's still on the main page, which means that it got some attention, so it stayed at the top, and it got a lot of comments, and this is not my group. This is a big group called Network Marketing Revolution, and it has 3,836 people in here because all of the big MLM leaders kind of run this page. And they won't let you put links on here that are actually something that would be spammy. Like, you can't put something in here that's just about your business Unless it's a blog that tells about something, they're okay with that because they do that too. But this was about telling about phone phobia, which I've had in the past, and I understand people have a real struggle with that. So I did something about, told a story about it, and then I also let them have a link to my blog, which was the complete story. But again, it wasn't so that I could get them in my business, although they will eventually be interested in that because they're seeing me share value. This is what I mean by value, is things like this. Telling a story about something that has happened that you have overcome. Telling a story about how somebody or yourself has overcome something valuable and has learned something valuable from that experience. Those kind of things people like to hear. They like to understand. And I got some really good reviews already. And this has only been a few hours that I put this up. What's the name of what fan page? Are you talking about mine or someone else's? But anyway, again, we also have, and we've learned how, a majority of you have learned how to create your own fan pages. And like I said tonight, we're not going to actually go into making one, but you also want to build your brand with your fan page. And I've shown this before, but I don't know if you remember it, and I think it's worth it to go over it again. When you come in as the fan page name, as you noticed, I actually switched as I came over, because if you look over here, now it says use Facebook as Lynda. So if I use that, I go back to myself instead of the fan page administrator. And you'll notice that I have a lot of likes that I've been in. And one of the things, if you've liked a few pages, and you can like each other with it too, if you click this, it opens up a box of anything that you've already liked. And if you haven't done a lot of liking with your fan page yet, I recommend that you try to do that at least 3 to 5 a day. And part of that is so that you can actually go into those fan pages and comment. And I have a lot of kind of guru types that I've liked, as well as I've liked all of you guys that are already got fan pages. And be careful not to do that too much to each other, but here, for instance, is one of the gurus. So I could come into her page, and she always shares a lot of great value. So let's see what she has to say here that I could make a comment. Now, this is another place you don't leave a link, but you say something of value on the page. This is a good one. She said, as a business owner, if you don't earn, you don't eat. How will you earn your keep today? That's a really good comment, and we're saying something. So, I will consistently, oh, I didn't spell that right. I don't know if you know this, but if you right click on a word that's misspelled, it will bring up some choices for spelling so that you won't misspell words. It's a good idea to make sure you spell your words right. I will consistently talk to new people daily. So I'm saying something about my commitment to my own business because she's asking about that in this post that she put up. So make sure that what you do put up is consistent and congruent with what is being said in that web, in that particular fan page. But guess what? 11,000 people probably would be able to see that. And then they can actually link over back to my page from that comment. I didn't create this link. That happened merely because I made a comment on this post that she just did here. Okay, everybody can see and hear, I hope. Everything's good. So I'm going to go back and look at, see if there's someone else that we want to talk to. Okay, here's another guru in multi-level marketing. And she generally shares a lot of good stuff on her page. Now, if they share a blog, which, of course, those are good to go and look at and maybe even comment on, that takes a little more time. And you want to think things out if they say something that actually requires some thought. So make sure that, and I don't want to say anything again because it looks like the activity isn't often enough to say something again on that page. You also have to be sensitive not to be the only participant in that page. If you see that happening, then maybe you don't do it as often. So you just choose a few of these kinds of pages. Oh, well. Here she's actually telling a story of her journey, kind of interesting, and very few people have actually commented. It's also really great if you're not one of the, you know, at the bottom of the comment list, but maybe closer to the top. There's only 3 comments, so mine will still be close to the top. So tonight I'm just congratulating her, celebrating with her that she has created success for herself in a year's time. Okay. Everybody's doing okay then? You can hear me and you're getting some value from this? Not seeing that? Okay. Good. All right. So I'm not going to do that all night, but that's just one of the things you can do. And then another thing you'll want to do probably, I like to go, well, I have to change back to me because this fan page doesn't let me do it as my fan page. But here's another thing I like to do all the time, is go to pages like this. This is one of my favorites, and I think a lot of you have jumped on this one because he's got a lot more help here than he did, and probably a lot of you joined him. But he's got 43,000 people in here or more, and it grows pretty much daily. So we have people in here that are really intense, strong networkers. They would be the kind of people that you would want to be associated with, because you're always looking for people. You don't want just anybody, you want people that actually are serious about their business, and they are if they're in here, because these are people that have really looked for the personal development, the help, and the things that they want in their life. And sometimes I create my own status in here. I always leave something of value. I don't put a link. He doesn't like links in here. Some of them really will get incensed about you putting links in, but they'll still be able to go back to your profile, so that's not a problem. So here this lady has left a nice comment that I like, and it was 4 hours ago. Nobody's done anything earlier than that apparently. Another thing you can actually do, let's go real quick and pick up brainy quotes. It's BRAINYQUOTES. This is one of my, you know, it's brainyquote.com. There's no S in there, I'm sorry. And what I like about this has got all of the major authors of the personal development. Like, for instance, Jim Rohn is, I know to a fact, is one of Eric Worre's favorites. So I'm going to pick up one of his quotes and put it in there because he likes that stuff. Got to make sure it's congruent with that person's page. So it's bringing up Jim Rohn quotes, which I want. So you want to find something that actually has some power behind it, because he does have some really good stuff. And I want to do something that's not always quoted, so I think this is one I don't see a lot of. So I'm going to go back in there and paste that in there as my status on his page, and he's going to be okay with that. And what's nice about doing that is, of course, you have your link. They can come back and get acquainted with you. I often get friend requests just from doing this. Another thing you can do is actually go to a person. I don't know if this is a fan page or a person. It's a fan page. So that one is being allowed to do that. That's interesting. Because my fan page won't allow me. And then you can, I think I'm already friends with him. Oh, another thing you can do is actually go up here and view. So these are all friends that are in my friends list. And these are people that are actually supposed to be in Aurora. I didn't know he was in Aurora. Interesting. So you can come down here, and some of the fan pages will actually let you see all of the fans. But, for instance, we have this fellow here, Wesley. Oh, he's also a fan page. They must have changed that because I couldn't get in before at all. Oh, losing my voice. How do you get people in the network industry if you have not yet met them? I'm Sam. I'm actually giving you one of the possible really good ways to do that. If you go to this fan page I just talked about, Network Marketing Pro. This is all network marketers, 43,000 worth of them. Even just by doing what I just did right now can actually create an interest in you so that they come and ask and be friends with you. But you can also do this. You can come up and do a search. And instead of taking a particular page, come all the way down, if it'll let you, it's supposed to let you, all results, and then you'll have where it shows up, and you want to get either groups or pages, not people, and then you can actually come into some of these groups. You don't even have to be friends with them, I don't think, just to look at them. Let me see if it lets you see their friends. Some of them it does and some of it doesn't. But here's one. Oh, this is worth being friends in. This one, this has got 7,056 members. And it actually lets you see the friends on this one. So if you can see them, you can ask them to be friends. So I've got quite a few that are already in this group. But when you're new at network marketing and you're new at trying to build your better web builder list, this is one of the ways that you could do that, is to be more friendly with this kind of group of people, because these are probably all network marketers. I hope that helps. Many of those I'm already friends with because I have over 4,000 people. Okay, I don't see a new question. But you've got several big groups here. When I brought up network marketing, these are probably all groups that actually got converted in the new groups. There were some that were the old format. As you can see, here's the one I just showed you, but there's 1, 2, 3, 4 others that are actually fairly good-sized groups here that you could be part of, you can contribute to, and I recommend that you are in some groups because you can contribute quotes and valuable stuff, you can comment on other people's stuff, and you can share things that are of value. Now make sure it's not about your better web builder. They won't appreciate it if you do that in there. But you can do it on your own page and your own profile. And then when people start seeing you participate in these groups, then they will be interested in knowing more about you. And probably the best step first is to go and ask to join. Most of them are, you got to get permission to join, and then they will let you come in, and most of them won't say no. They want members in there. And if you scroll down, there is still even a few more that are pretty good sized here. This is the one that I showed you earlier, but here's several others that are good sized groups. And I might go and join a bunch of these myself, because there's always an opportunity to meet new people that way. So that answers that one, I hope. Go and join groups. Go and share content. Go and talk to people. When you come into these groups, like I showed you here, you can actually see all over here on the side for most of them. And when you do that link, see all, it lets you see all the people that are in the group. And since you're probably not friends with many of them, you'd have the opportunity. First of all, let's play with Cindy for a minute. Obviously, I'm already friends with her. But Cindy's a better web builder and a good friend of mine. But if I was not friends with her yet, I would go and look at her profile. I would go ahead and add her as friend, which would be up here. And somebody asked today, how do you message them? I would add and then message at the same time. You do the add first and then the message. And then just say, I just saw you in such and such group. I'd like to get acquainted more. I'd like to make a connection. We're both in network marketing. And you could say something like, what do you like best about that group we're in? Something like that. I would not recommend immediately trying to convince her to look at your better web builder on the very first time that you had connection with her. I sometimes put it in my signature, but I also am showing them friendliness too. So let's see. Okay, is there anybody from Europe in the room? I don't know. You'd have to look at the flags, Margot. I don't know if there is or not. I don't see any. Because of the lateness of the hour, it's probably tough for many of them to be in there. Yeah. I know you are. But it's probably, for the lateness of the hour, difficult for a lot of the European. So, for instance, let's find somebody I don't have a friendship with yet. Here we go. Here's a few that I don't have a friend with. And what I prefer to do, other than add them right here, although it gives you that permission to do that, I prefer to go to their actual profile. So I'll open that in a new tab. So now it's showing me a little bit about him. I still go and look at him, even though it says he's in the network marketing group there. I still go and look. there is a possibility that he's not, you know, because sometimes insurance and real estate and some of those like to get in these groups because they're looking for customers. But I'm not looking for an insurance agent or a real estate agent. And he's a network marketing pro as well. Very good chance that he's a network marketer. I like to see if he's got a personal information. Most of the network marketers have realized they want to put something in here. If you haven't, you do want to go back and do that. So I'm a speaker and trainer on relationship building through network marketing. Well, that makes him interesting, doesn't it? He does somewhat the same thing I do. Has been an entrepreneur since his first business venture at age 5. Wow. He's been working as an entrepreneur for a really long time. Okay. Oh, I see one thing that wouldn't be something I'd be excited about, but that's okay. He has a lot of interesting things about himself here. He has told us a lot. And we also know that he is a network marketer. He's in send out cards. So that's a very good sign that he could be a good choice to talk to. He lives in California, Los Angeles. He's got a great picture with a smile. He's doing a lot of the right things. I can't tell how many friends he has because he's hidden them. But that's not important. He probably has quite a few. He just doesn't want them to be hit on by people. So the first thing you want to do is add him as a friend, and subscribe happens automatically if you do that. You have the option. You have the option to subscribe if you don't, even if you don't want to. Even if you don't want to actually be friends with them. And that's handy in a case where maybe you've already done enough adding that it could be a problem. Okay, that was it. Network Marketing Pro. So I'm just trying to start a conversation with him. I'm going to keep it very loose. It's not about my trying to push anything on him. He's obviously a fairly... I don't know if that's correct or not. He's obviously a fairly successful network marketer. You know, I'm not looking for somebody that is... in my case, I'm looking for people that are a little more successful. I mean, you can choose. I mean, everybody can use the tool. Everybody can use the help. And you can choose who you want to be with. Okay. Yeah, absolutely, Craig. I love to ask questions because it really opens them up. They love to answer those kind of questions. And that is a great way to start it, because you don't immediately want to say, would you like to look at my tool? Well, that's a really good way to shut it down real fast. So I'm looking some more here. Looking for somebody that just looks interesting. I don't know a lot about any of the ones in here. I haven't done this for a while. And there's going to be different ones all the time. Some come, some go. It's got a great looking picture. These are probably blog entries. Maybe. And wow, doesn't show the older stuff. Let's see, he lives in Washington. Oh, and he lives in South Carolina now. I've never lived there, so that is not something I have in common with him. Let's see what else I have possibly in common. Of course, he likes Think and Grow Rich. That's pretty thin, though, to be talking about that. Everybody loves that book. And there's no link. I might skip him for now. Got a great picture, though. Is there any questions while we're in the house here? Yeah, I definitely recommend doing pictures. Yeah, you gotta make it real. I mean, think about this. How would you start having a conversation if you were in a real party and you wanted to get acquainted with some of the better movers and shakers in the bunch? How would you start that conversation? You have to think about it like that. What would you do? Would you immediately say, well, guess what? I have a business. Would you like to see it? Probably not. That's not a real good choice. So you want to start out by finding out about them, because they love to talk about themselves. So find something you can ask them about them. Because this isn't about me at this point. It's about them. Okay, it says she's an owner president of what? And she hasn't put anything at the top. She doesn't know how to do that part. Don't have to be great to start, but have to start in order to be great. I like that quote. That's all she put in there. Not much information about her. One of my pet peeves is when people don't put any information in here and then they want you to communicate with them. So they make you have to fish around, and I don't want to go to their Facebook page to find out about them. I'm not going to join them just on their Facebook page. I want to find out about them as a person first. Okay, she likes Cedric Harris, which is one of the big stars in the MLSP. Don't see very much about her, so you can see what I mean. You don't want to fish too much. You want to find something pretty fast, because you want to do that, at least 10 to 15 times in a day. You can break it up. It doesn't have to be all at once, but you don't want to make it real hard. And if that person, here's another thing too. I get invited to be friends with people all day long. It looks like one, but I actually have not come back in here, 59 requests. I have not come back in here all day, and I want to share something with you that's important. When you go to look at your own profile, I want you to look and see how people are going to notice you or not notice you based on what you've put on your profile. And this is not a basics about what's on your profile, but think about it this way. If you don't make it easy for people to figure out who you are they going to do that? Probably not. And I don't know if we have anybody that's done this tonight. I don't like cartoons. I like people to have real faces. This lady looks interesting. Let's go look at her. Ah, here's one of those ones that does not invite me. You know why? No information. She's locked it. The only thing I know about her is that she's female and that she lives in wherever that is. It's not in our country. And she graduated in 2004. I know very little about this lady because she did not make it possible for me to find out. She's new. Okay, this is how we know. Because we can tell right here, she's pretty new. She has only 31 friends. And she has just recently started to put her information in here. And there are no more posts today. She started this week on this. So she's really, really new. But I can tell you right now, as one of the leaders in multi-level, and I'm not bragging, it's the truth, I'm less likely to say yes because I don't know anything about her. Number two, she didn't send me a message either. I recommend you do that now. It's getting more and more important to do that. When you say hello and I want to be your friend, take the time to say hi and ask and tell them who you are. And this is somebody that's actually in our training room tonight, probably. Kay, are you in our training room? I'll check and see. Is Kay here? If I know that you are in here and you've taken the time to tell me, then it's easier and I can say yes to that. I don't see her now. Unless she put a different name up. Okay. Where are we? Okay, so I've got too many windows up. So Kay is requesting to be friends, and she also gave me a message. Or did she? Yep, no, she's not here. Okay, she's just acknowledging that she heard my training. So I can message her back. But she's probably, I know that name. I saw that in the Skype room earlier. She's one of the new affiliates. Yeah, I know, Michelle. And I do recommend also, we've got a lot of people just using their front name, first names here. It's really a good idea to use both names, and let me tell you why. It's because, especially for me, I mean, if I know, if I can make the connection between your first, both your first and last name, like I see in the Skype room or I see you in Facebook, and I make the connection, it makes it a lot easier. If I don't see you and I don't know where you are, I don't make the connection, I may not say yes. So make it easy to make the connection. Make it easy to figure out who this person is that wants to be friends with me. Send a message. Make sure that your content, your information is available even though I haven't said yes to the friendship yet so that I can find out about you. That's important. So we've even gotten a little bit past the hour. So has anybody any other questions? I kind of covered a little bit different stuff tonight, but I felt like that was important. One of the things that's really, really important, as you're putting together, let me show you where you do this because you may not know it, but when you're putting together your personal information, there's a way to make sure that you make it available to people so that even if they are not your friends yet, they will be able to see it. And this is how you do it. You come in here and you have these choices, public, friends, or custom. Okay? So how you connect. You can edit this. So here is the major things that you want to make sure show up. Who can post on your walls? That you can keep open or not, depending. But you want to keep your posts open, public, in other words. You want to keep your Facebook messages for everyone, unless it's a specific thing that goes to just your friends, and you can do that as an individual post, not the whole thing. And who can send your friends requests? You want to say everyone. Who can look up your profile name or contact info? Everyone. If you change that to friends, that means that your whole profile is locked, and then nobody can see your information. And I had somebody argue with me about that the other day, and I really recommend, do you see how many people that I have to go and say hi to and say yes to? If you have somebody you really want to make friends with, and there's somebody that's already been involved with Facebook for a while, don't make it so hard. Make sure that you keep all of it public. Yeah, there is actually, Deanna. The way that shows, now they just changed this. This is another thing that got changed recently. Is now you have, this was just real new, and it's just building a little bit at a time. But just a few days ago, there was no subscribers, and now there's 52. And this is going to grow because this is brand new. It just started. And these people are people that have actually requested friendships as well. And some of them are not my friends. And some of them are. And they've decided to subscribe. And you have a choice to do that. Oh, and here's another good one. I better tell you this too because this is awesome. I just found out this today. If you see somebody posting something that you don't like, now I don't have anything that I can see, but oh, I don't like this very much. Say I didn't like this. So I go over to him and I say, I'm not going to unsubscribe because that's the first thing I've seen that I don't like. But if I see something that I found it really objectionable, it's obscene in some way, like somebody putting up ugly pictures that are nudes or something like that, you can actually unsubscribe without unfriending. Did you know that? This is new. So you could come down here and unsubscribe, and that means that you wouldn't get any of these on your main feed. And that's really good to know if you see things that you don't like, but yet you're maybe you want to have connection with them. In my case, if it's really obnoxious stuff I don't want to see on my feed, I might do both. So unsubscribe and unfriend. But both of those are right here in that person's profile, right at the top now. They've moved it all up here. I think that makes it a whole bunch easier to get around and to figure it out and keep track of your friends. That should answer that. And is there any other questions? Yeah. Yeah, if you have somebody that's swearing, doing things that are just you don't find very uplifting, to say the least, you don't have to be subscribed to them. You don't have to be friends with them. And if they are your actual personal friends, you could actually hide their posts if you wanted to. It's not on your wall, Marionette. It's on that person's wall. So you would go to their profile, and then it's right here. I'm just using him as an example. I'm not actually going to unsubscribe because I don't find that totally impossible to live with, but unless I saw a lot of that stuff. Now, when I see somebody showing pictures of nude, almost nude pictures or things like that, or I don't like real obscene political stuff or religious stuff either. I try to keep my page generic, so I don't want all that on my page. So if there's something on the home page I'm particularly offended by, that's how you get rid of it. You can just unsubscribe to it. You don't want to see it, and it'll immediately go away, which is really cool. They just started that. I don't see anything that I find objectionable, but you know what I mean. And of course, this feed changes constantly. The pictures have gotten a lot bigger, which is kind of fun. You can actually see them better now. I know a lot of people are challenged with the new things that are going on with the Facebook, but most of it I find to be extremely helpful and going to be a lot better as you get used to it. And you just have to get on there and play and figure out where things are, because most of it is actually going to be easier to find now than it was. You don't have to go into your menu and edit friends. It's right there on your profile, and to get to your friends as well. I really appreciate you being here, Margot, and you have a good night, what's left of it. Okay, any more questions? How you doing? You understand what we went over? But that's pretty much what I have to share. I try to keep it not too many crazy things at once, because then that way you... then you get confused. So go out, find new friends, go into the groups and find friends, because you're going to find the majority of the really good networkers there. You're welcome. I really appreciate you coming. Yeah, put it to use right away. That's the best way to make sure that you understand it, is to put it to use. Yeah, training and education mean nothing if you have not actually been able to use it. I didn't see you there, Legia. I'm glad you came. Good night, everyone. Have a wonderful night. And let me know tomorrow how you're doing with all your new tools that I just gave you. Good night, everybody. Yeah, I need to eat. Ooh, get messy. Right. I don't care if it's a smaller group. Oh, okay. I can stop this too and see what happens now.